We are getting more details following the G7 leaders' summit called to tackle escalating tensions in the Middle East following Iran's massive aerial strike on Israel over the weekend. Bloomberg reports the leaders have agreed to use all channels of influence on Israel not to launch a retaliatory attack on Iran. They also expressed some cautious optimism that Islamic State won't launch another wave of attacks anytime soon. Now, at the UN Security Council, the United States also warning Iran it will be held responsible if it takes further action against Israel or the U.S. The U.K. representative echoing the U.S. in condemning the attack.
In the coming days, and in consultation with other member states, the United States will explore additional measures to hold Iran accountable here at the United Nations. More immediately, the Security Council must unequivocally condemn Iran's aggressive actions and call for Iran and its partners and proxies to cease their attacks. If Iran or its proxies take actions against the United States or further action against Israel, Iran will be held responsible.
As we have demonstrated, the United Kingdom will continue to stand up for Israel's security and for that of all our regional partners, including Jordan and Iraq. We welcome the actions of our allies to deter the Iranian threat.
Turkish, Jordanian, and Iraqi officials meanwhile say Iran gave wide notice before Saturday's attack, allowing mass casualties and rampant escalation to be averted. The U.S., however, denies receiving an extensive warning, saying Tehran only sent a message after the attacks began. In the meantime, Israel remains on high alert. Most of the hundreds of drones and missiles launched by Iran were downed even before reaching Israel. The overnight barrage was its first ever direct assault on Israeli territory and came in retaliation for a deadly strike on Tehran's consulate in the Syrian capital. It remains unclear how Israel would respond to this major escalation in the long-running covert war between regional foes.
Last night was a proof that Iran seeks escalation. Iran launched over 350 threats, ballistic missiles, cruise missiles, rockets, and suicide drones towards Israel, and also other countries in the region could have got that threat on the way. Iran doesn't just pose a threat to Israel, Iran poses a threat to the entire Middle East. Iran, from the beginning of the war, wants only one thing, to escalate the region. Until now, she worked through her proxies, but now she revealed, trying to escalate the region herself.
Oil, of course, will be of close focus, and one key question for the region and for oil will be the safety of vessels around the Strait of Hormuz. While Iran may struggle to block the key choke point, it can certainly step up attacks, adding to existing disruption in the Red Sea and to oil's risk premium. The Philippine Energy Department explains around 21 million barrels per day pass through that strait, and if this is shut, risks delaying supplies, forcing vessels to find another route, most likely longer and more expensive. Meanwhile, Clean Fuels Bong Suntay expects petroleum products to see another price hike next week. That would be a fifth week of upward adjustments already following this week's big pop. He notes Middle East supplies the 40% of global crude oil exports. As it is, Brent crude is already up almost 20% this year and last traded around $90 a barrel.